Dr. T.V. Geeta, Professor, Department of Computer Science, College of Engineering, Guindy, Anna University. Her special interest, Artificial Intelligence and Natural Language. She has published more than 143 articles in national and international journals. She has guided around 7 PhD students. She has got Young Scientist Award from Government of Tamil Nadu in the year 2000, Chief Minister's Special Mention Award in the year 2002 and Woman of Excellence by Rotary Club in the year 2003.
Welcome to the UGC lecture series. In this lecture, we are going to talk about a type of sorting algorithm called the heap sort. Now, sorting is a very important part of any application in computer science in many fields. Now, we are going to look at, there are many sorting algorithms available, but we are going to look at one particular algorithm called the heap sort. Now, before we go to the heap sort algorithm, we have to define what is a heap and we have to know how to insert and delete elements from a heap. So, in this lecture, I am going to talk about the insertion, what is a heap and how to insert into a heap and how to delete in the heap. In the next lecture, I will be talking about using this heap to do a heap sort algorithm. So, here we are going to only talk about construction of a heap basically. So, let us start off by looking at what is sorting. So, what is sorting? Sorting is an operation that segregates items into groups according to a specific criterion. Depending on the type of elements, you can have different types of criterion. For example, if you have a numerical example like this, you can sort this in ascending order. This is a sorting according to ascending order. You can also do the sorting according to descending order. If it was alphabets, then you have a lexicograph or words, you have lexicographic order. We have already seen in the case of binary trees what is a lexicographic order. It could be any numerical, string, character, whatever. Some criterion you have to have for doing the sorting. So, sorting books in a library, this is according to the catalog number. Sorting individuals by height like feet and inches, these are examples of sort. Sorting movies in a blockbuster, which is the alphabetical order. Sorting numbers in a sequential way. So, there are many types of sorting algorithms. Some of them we are going to list. There are many different types of sorting algorithms. Lots of research has gone into sorting algorithms, and these are some established algorithms we are looking at. Bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, merge sort, shell sort, heap sort, quick sort, radix sort and swap sort. Some of this are external sorting. I will explain what is external sorting and internal sorting. External sorting means it needs extra space and it is done outside in the external memory, while some of it is done in the internal memory. This is a big criterion, especially when sorting algorithms are first designed, because of the cost of memory and the large amount of data that you had to sort, because databases needs hundreds and thousands and lakhs of records that you have to sort. So, external sort and internal sort were also there. Now, we are going to look at one of the sorts, the heap sort. So, first before, as I already told you, in this lecture, we are going to look at only what a heap is. We are not going to look at the heap sort per se. So, what is a heap? Now, let us look at what is a heap. Before we go to what is a heap, we have to define what is complete binary trees. I have already spoken to you about complete binary trees, but just to refresh, a complete binary tree is a tree where a node can have only 0 or 2 children, okay, and all the leaves as far as possible are on the same depth. So, this is a complete and a full binary tree. Each node has, the leaves have 0 children and all other nodes have 2 children. So, if you look here, at the height 0 there is 1 node, at height 1 there are 2 nodes, at height 2 there are 4 nodes, at height 3 there are 8 nodes. So, at height d there will be 2 to the power of d. This is a property of a complete binary tree. So, a number of nodes and height, a complete binary tree with n nodes will have height order of log n. This also we have discussed previously. And a complete binary tree with height h has d plus 1 minus d to the power of 2 to the power of d nodes, in other words. So, a complete binary tree. Now, what is the advantage of this complete binary tree? We are talking about complete binary tree. It can be stored, this is the most important issue here. It can be stored in an array using level order traversals. Please note, I will just explain again what is level order traversal. Start from here, go here, finish this, come here. So, that is level order traversals. Remember, we had in order traversal, pre order traversal, post order traversal. Here we are talking about level order traversal, that is this node first, then traverse this, then traverse this, then traverse this. That is the order we are going to follow. Now, this particular tree is going to be maintained in an array. Remember, binary trees were normally represented using doubly linked list. We are not going to use that, we are going to use an array. So, for any element in array position I, its left child will necessarily reside in position 2i and its right child will reside in position 2i plus 1 and its parent will reside in position I by 2. So, this is the condition that we are going to use for the construction of a heap. So, given an element in I, the left child will be in position 2i, right child will be in position 2i plus 1 and similarly given a node I, you can find its parent as I by 2. So, let us take this example. So, you have see remember it will be stored like this 26, 24, 11, 7, 6, 8, 4, 1, 3, 5. Now, let us take one node. Let us take node 7, its parent is 4 by 2, so its parent is 24 I by 2 and its children are at 2i and 2i plus 1, that is 8 and 9, that is 1 and 3, this is not a complete binary tree. So, it is at 8, 1 and 3. So, that is the complete binary tree, this is not a heap. A complete binary tree and it is represented like this. We have not described a heap yet. This is a heap, but we have not described that. So, the advantage of doing this is its height is at most log n. The left and right pointers are not needed because we are using an array and it allows you instant access, random access, allows two directional traversal. You can go from here to here, you can go from root to leaves and leaves to root. So, now that is a complete binary tree. Up to now what we have done, we have just define what is a complete binary tree and we have said that the complete binary tree is going to be stored in an array using level by level traversal and we have also said that given a node I, its parent is I by 2 and its children are 2i and 2i plus 1 respectively. Now, we are going to use the same property and we are going to assume the data is stored in the tree in some order, we will assume less than or equal to. So, a heap is defined as a complete binary tree which you have already defined, such that every parent's data is greater than or equal to its child, if it has only one child or children's data. This is an additional constraint we are putting on a complete binary tree that we have seen before and we are calling it a heap. So, look here 17, the parent is less than its children, parent is less than its children. There is no left and right and things like that we saw in lexicographic tree. Just says that the parent is greater than the children, the parent is greater than the children, that is all. So, that is the condition we are putting. So, let us look at this. This is an example of a heap. Again 14 and 10 are less than 16, 8 and 7 are less than 14, 4 and 1 are less than 7 and 9 and 3 are less than 10. So, now let us, that is a heap. Okay. Here we assume that the parent is greater than the children. Now, heaps are almost complete binary trees, all levels are full except possibly the lowest level. And if the lowest level is not full, then the nodes must be packed to the left. That is only after these two are have children will you get a child here. That is without having children here, you cannot have children here. That is why you call packed to the left. So, it has 2h to 2h plus 1 minus 1 nodes with height h. The structure is so regular that it can be represented in an array and no links are necessary. We saw that before. So, now, you can have a complete binary tree that satisfies the heap property. Key of each node is less than the keys of its children, then it is called a minimum heap. key of each node is greater than the keys of its children, it is called a maximum heaps. Now we are going into a slight difference. We have two types of heap, one called the maximum heap and the other called the minimum heap. So, the maximum heap here, you have 14 which is greater than its children, 12 greater than its children, 7 greater than its children. Note that the nodes are packed to the left. Then you have the minimum, the parent is less than its children, the parent is less than its children, the parent is less than its child. Again the nodes are packed to the left. Here the key of each node is greater than its children, the key of each node is less than its children. If the key is greater, it is called max heap of the parent is greater. If the key of the parent is less than the children, it is called the min heap. So, you can have an array implementation of a heap again. So, here you have A, B, C, D, you do not use 0, so that you have that I property. Now, if you look here, this is a binary heap, you can represent it this way. It is a level representation. A is less than alphabetically less than B and C, B is alphabetically less than D and E, D is alphabetically less than this and so on. So, this is a typical min heap as far as the alphabetic order is concerned. Again the property, if you take 4, its parent is at 2, its parent is at 2, D, its children is at 8 and 9. So, that is the idea of the, you can easily find the addresses. Okay, so that is what we have. So, again just to repeat, for any element in an array position I, the left child will be at 2i, the right child will be at 2i plus 1 and its parent will be at I by 2. Of course, if you have 3 also, the parent will be at 1, 5 also the parent will be at 2. Possible problem that you can encounter is an estimate of the maximum heap size is required in advance, but we can resize if necessary. And even if we draw the heaps as trees for our visualization purposes, the actual implementation is using arrays, and this is one of the primary issues as far as heap is concerned. That is, it is represented using an array because of its complete property. There is no there will not be any space in between the arrays because of that. It is not wise to store normal binary trees in arrays because there you will have number of locations which will be free, because there is no guarantee that it is a complete binary tree packed to the left. So, this is a heap as an array, just to emphasize again. So, this is a max heap, 16 greater than this, 14 greater than this and so on. So, again we have already seen this example, 4 parent is at 2 and or let us take 2 parent is at 1 and children is at 2i, that is 4 and 5. So, back to priority queues, this is a heap where this is a min heap. This is not a heap because here the parent is greater than the children, but here the parent is less than its child. So, you cannot have a min max mixed heap, you can have only either a min heap or a max heap. So, the value of each node is less than or equal to the values of both its descendants, then it is called a min heap. Or if it is each node is greater than or equal to the values of both its descendants, then it is called a max heap. It is easy both conceptually and practically to perform insert and delete min in heap if the heap order property is maintained. So, the use of a binary heap is so common for a priority queue implementation, thus the word heap is usually assumed to be an implementation of the data structure. This is not true, but then because of this property of using the level by level transfer thing, and a queue is a typical data structure to implement the heap. So, the primary priority queue and the heap are considered to be synonyms with each other, but actually it is not true, it is a data structure that is used for representing the heap. So, again let us look at the heap properties. Heap supports the following operations efficiently: it inserts in log order of log n time, it locates the current minimum in one log order of one time, and deletes the current minimum in order of log n. The accessing the location of an element is typically of the random, immediately you can access because you know the index, you can go directly, but insertion and deletion take log n, which is fine. So, we have just looked at the heap properties. Now, let us take a small break. After we come back from the break, we are going to discuss the two algorithms, the insertion algorithm and the deletion algorithm. Welcome back after the break. before the break, we had seen what is a heap, and we have looked at some the array representation of a heap, which is essentially a level by level traversal of the tree. And because if it was a complete binary tree, we could find the addresses of the children and the parent easily by just looking at the index of the array, and that was the advantage of heap represented as an array. Now, let us look at a min heap. This is a typical example of a min heap. Now, you look here, 5 is less than 6 and 15, 6 is less than 7 and 20, 7 is less than 9, 15 is less than 16 and 18, and it has been represented as 5, 6, 15, 7, 20, 16, 18 and 9. Now, the idea is that given any node, you can find its children. Given the index of any node, in other words, index in the array of any node, you can find its parent and its children. Now, let us look at the insertion algorithm. Now, I want to insert the element 3. Now, if I want to insert the element 3, if I insert it here, this is a place where it is not full, but now the heap property is not satisfied. 3 has to be, the parent is greater than 3. So, this is the problem with this. So, if you do this insertion like this, so we have to solve this. So, how do we solve this? What we do here is, we take this 3 and put it at the root. So, we take the 3 and put it at the root and shift the root to 5. Please note it was here. So, you shift 5 here and you shift 6 here and shift 7 here. Okay. Now, it is a heap. 3 is less than 5 and 15, 5 is less than 6 and 20, 6 is less than 9 and 7. So, it follows the heap property. I will just explain again how we did this. What we did is when we want to insert any number, we insert it at the last position in the array where it is empty. Okay. So, that is what we did, and then we replaced this value in the root, and then you kept percolating down till you had the heap property satisfied. Okay. So, if you put 3 here, then you had 5. So, you take 5 and put it here, then you take 6 and put it here, and so on. Okay. So, what I do is I take the last node and put it here and then delete the 3 and see whether the, now, but 7 is greater than 5 and 15. So, I cannot put 7 here. So, I will take it and put in the 7 here and take 5. I have to take the least of these two, because if the 15 goes here, then again the min property is not satisfied. So, I take 5 and put it here, 7 comes here. Again, I have to see whether the property is satisfied, not satisfied. So, 6 goes here and 7 comes here. This way I delete the minimum. Here I had to delete 3. For that purposes, what I did was I just replaced the 3 by 7 and then try to maintain the heap property. So, this is the idea of, the next is change key 6 to 17. Suppose I want to just change a key number, I do not want to do any insertion or deletion. So, I want to change this to 17. Now, what happens, again the property is not satisfied. So, 17, 720, I will replace 7 here and bring 17 here. Again, the property is not satisfied. So, I have to bring here. So, this is the final tree. So, in all the 3 cases, what we have done is, we have done an insertion, we have deleted a minimum value. The minimum value will be at the root. So, we have done that, and we have also changed the key value. In all cases, you had to do a exchange of values such that the heap property is maintained, in this case the min heap. So, suppose you want to make a heap from an array, this is a case of again a, okay. So, what you do is you put 10, 8, 12, 5, 20, 6, 4, 2 and then see whether the property is satisfied. Now, what happens, 10, let us look here, 10, 8, 12. What we did here was, I will start from the bottom, 6, 4 and 12. So, 4 goes there. So, that property satisfied here. Then you had 5 and 2, min heap, we are looking at max heap. So, that is okay. Then 8 to 20. So, 2 goes here. 8 to 20, 2 has to go here. So, that is what happens. Then again this property has to be satisfied. Then 2, 4, 10, this 2 goes here. So, that is your final 2 is less than 5 and 4, 5 is less than 8 and 20, 8 is less than 10, 4 is less than 6 and 12. Let us go through this once again and see exactly what we have done. So, I had an array, I just put the array in whatever way it came, 8, 10, 12. And this was our original array. So I just drew the array. Now I have to maintain a min heap property. So first I take these two and find that 4 has to come here, 12 has to come here. This part has been maintained. Now I come here, 2 will come here, 5 will come here. So that is over. Now I have 2 here and 20 here and 8 here. So 2 has to go here and 8 has to come here. But when 8 comes here, 8 and 5, 5 has to come here, 8 has to come here. So you may have to redo the exchange of nodes in order to maintain the min heap property. Now what happens? I have 2 and 4 and 10. So 2 has to go there. But when I bring 10 here, again the property changes. So I have to do this. But the advantage here is that whenever I want to find a child or I want to find a parent, I will just check whether the property is maintained by its children. If it is not, I will have to do the interchange. So the algorithm for the insertion: add the new element to the next available position at the lowest level. So that means the array's empty position, next empty position. Restore the min heap property if violated. General strategy is to percolate up or bubble up. If the parent of the element is larger than the element, then interchange the parent and the child. That is what we have done. So here suppose I want to insert 2.5, I just insert 2.5. Now if I look at 2.5 and 6 and 5, 2.5 is less, min heap again. So 5 comes down. So I have 2.5 here. So I have swapped. Okay. Now I have 2.5, 2 and 1. Okay. So the property has been satisfied. Now the pseudocode for this is current size. I have an array only as an implementation, so I do that, and this is for maintaining that, adding that element, resizing if required, and here I am doing that. Please note there is no question of how I am going to do find the parent, because it is I by 2, and how I am going to find the child is just 2i and 2i plus 1. That is the main advantage of the heap sort algorithm itself. We are not talking about heap sort here. We are just talking about inserting into an element. We will be again and again using this inserting when we are doing the inserting and deleting when we are doing the heap sort algorithm. So suppose I want to insert 14. What I do is I put 14 here. Okay. Now again this is a min heap algorithm. So 14 if I put here, it violates the heap. Okay. So the 14 will go here. So I have 14 here, 31 comes here. Now 14, 24, 21, again the property is violated. So this 21 will come here and 14 will go there. Now I have 14, 13, 16, the property is satisfied and I have the insertion algorithm. It's a simple case where I didn't have to change many things. Delete min, that is the insertion algorithm. So what did I do in the insertion algorithm? I just, please remember, what is this place? How do I decide where I have to insert here? In the array, I will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10th location will be occupied by 32. In the 11th position, I put 31. Automatically, it will become the child of 5. 5 will have 10 and 11 as children. Then I just keep checking the parents such that the heap property is satisfied, and then I finish it. Next, let us look at delete min. So the min will always be at the root. If it is a root, if it is a delete min algorithm, compare the two children of the root, make the lesser of the two the root, an empty spot is created, bring the lesser of the two children of the empty spot to the empty spot. Now a new empty spot is created and you keep continuing. That's the algorithm. So for example here, I want to delete the min, so I remove 1. Now the lesser of the two children is brought up, so 2 will be brought up. Now I have an empty space here. The lesser of the two children will be brought here. So 3 is brought here, and this is my new tree after deleting, sorry, here it is 2 after deleting 1. Heap property is preserved, but completeness is not necessarily preserved if you do it this way. Now that is a problem. So what we have to do? We have to change the algorithm. Copy the last number to the root. So instead of doing it this way, instead of directly removing the root, what we are doing is we will copy the last number to the root. So what we do is 20 will be put here, okay, and then you keep percolating down till the heap property is satisfied. Okay, so that is here. So what happens? Compare 20 with 7. So 7 goes up, 20 comes down. Compare 20 with now you have 20. You compare 20 comes here and 7 comes there and 20 comes here. Compare 20 with 9 and 16, so 9 goes there. Now 20, 17 and 18, 17 goes here. So that is your final Okay, so please note the deletement algorithm. Instead of directly removing the root, where if you do that, your complete tree property may be violated, though the heap may be satisfied. So what you do is you interchange the root node with the last node in that array, and then you do the maintenance of the heap property. So the same hole trick that has been used in the insertion can be used here also. So create a hole 2, 5. So again you create a hole, then I create a hole and fill the hole. So this is a delete mean. The algorithm is, if it is empty, it is an underflow, you cannot delete. Otherwise you copy the percolate down from root and then compare the root, replace it with the shortest child. So that is the algorithm. The bubble stops when you have finished the algorithm. Now let us look at some problems. Now in this, what we have done is we have constructed a heap. Please note that I started with heap sort, but I did not talk about sorting at all. We have just spoken about what a heap is. A heap is a complete binary tree where if it is not having all the leaves, then it will be packed to the left and it is stored in an array. The main advantage is that given the array indices of any node I can find its parent I by 2 and its children 2i and 2i plus 1. That is what makes this algorithm very, very efficient, because you are doing it only using arrays, and the property makes the arrays a typical way of implementing this. Now let us look at some problems. First, you have to differentiate between what is a max heap and a min heap, and given this, now what you do is you store this in an array and then you try to keep on exchanging values such that the max heap and min heap properties are satisfied. If you do that, you will understand how a heap is constructed. And we looked at three algorithms in this also. We looked at insert, we looked at delete, and here I am only talking about insert, but delete mean was also there. And even if you change a key value, you may have to do the manipulations to maintain the heap property. So that is it. Now we will, in the next lecture, we will talk about sorting using this heap tree. Thank you.